Beauty begins the moment you decide to be yourself. Info Booth 19. Today we are going to see how to prepare banana flower curry. So many people, they are, once they hear the term banana flower or once they see it, they are very scared to buy it. People will back off when they want to use banana flower in their cooking process. The reason is it's very difficult to peel. That's what people think. But in this video, we are going to see how to do preparation very quickly using this banana flower. And because it's a very healthy and tasty dish, so do not miss it. You have to try all these different kind of vegetables in your day-to-day life so that you can keep your family healthy. Banana flour is very rich in phosphorus, iron, calcium, magnesium, potassium and many compounds in it. So for preparing this curry, the ingredients which I show, we all need all those things. So first I am taking this banana flour. See, I am not going to use the entire banana flour here. I am going to use around 20 to 25 florets for this curry, and the remaining I'm going to use it for some other recipe. So you should take garlic, green chili, curry leaves, small onion, one tomato. For grinding, coconut, jeera, onion and tomato, salt, turmeric powder and 1 tablespoon coriander powder. So along with that, half lemon size tamarind I have soaked in water. And for tadka, urad dal, mustard, jeera and fenugreek seeds. So these are the ingredients we need for this curry. So chili powder you can take as per taste, because we are adding 2 chilies as well here, so you can adjust as per your taste. Now we'll see how to prepare banana flour. So you have to remove this layer by layer. If you find the banana flour little bit in black in color, throw that floret, do not use the floret. So once it is fresh and it is light in color, you can use those florets for cooking. If it is black in color, don't use it. So one by one, if you start peeling layer by layer, you can see more florets inside. So you have to go till deep down to take all the florets. For this recipe, I'm going to use only this much. So the remaining flour I'm going to use for some other recipe. And how to clean is, first when you just see, you can see the tallest stem that you need to remove. And down you can see one small plastic kind of paper thing that you need to remove. So if you keep seeing it, first 2 or 3 florets, it might take little bit of time extra, some 10 seconds or 15 seconds. But as you go, you will get to know the speed and you will start taking it faster. So it doesn't take much time. So all you need to do is remove the tallest stem, which will have one small round at the tip, and then down one small plastic cover kind of thing will be there. So these 2 things you have to remove. For working women who wants to who don't have time to spend in the morning time, what you can do is you can clean this, do the preparation, and you can put it in a little bit of water, buttermilk water and a pinch of salt. In that way you can prevent the florets not turning into black in color, and you can prevent from oxidizing. So I have grinded this masala with 1 onion, tomato, jeera and coconut. Along with that, you can add 1/2 tablespoon of sambar powder, that is purely optional. So in this soaked lemon water, what I am going to do is I am going to add salt to it, turmeric powder, chili powder and coriander powder. Mix well and keep it aside. Directly we can use it for cooking process. So anytime you peel the banana flower, immediately you put in buttermilk water, otherwise it will become black in color, and also the bitter taste will get reduced if you soak it in buttermilk water. So I have taken 2 to 3 tablespoons of gingerly oil. Use gingerly oil for this dish. Now add mustard, fenugreek, jeera and urad dal. Fenugreek gives more taste and it is a very healthy spice, I can say. So add in whatever dish possible, and to this dish it tastes really nice. Add more of garlic, curry leaves, fry it nicely. So the taste of the dish depends on how much you fry step by step. So once the garlic gets fried nicely, add this small onion. This small onion is very good for health, more than big onion. This small onion or sambar onion, it is very very good for health and it has lot of health benefits. Every day try to add little bit of small onions in your food in the cooking process. I know it is bit of costly, but you can add frequently in your dishes, because it keeps the body healthy. So now once the small onion gets fried nicely, add chopped tomatoes. Now fry till the tomatoes get cooked in the oil and it should be soft. Before you add the masala, tomato should be cooked perfectly. you can close the lid and cook so that tomato gets cooked faster. So now you see the tomatoes get cooked nicely. Now I am adding the ground masala in that. So this is going to be the base and it is going to bring the thickness to the curry. So add well, mix it well, and then allow it to boil. All the raw smell should go and the oil should get separated at the sides. So till then we need to cook that. I'm adding little bit of salt to it. Be careful in adding salt because we have added along with banana flour as well, and also in the tamarind water. Now once the oil gets separated, remove the banana flour from the buttermilk water and then add it to this curry. Once the raw smell goes, then only you need to add the banana flour. So it doesn't take much time to cook. Hardly it took 3 to 4 minutes after adding banana flour. So don't cook it too much for longer time, more than 10 minutes and all, because it turns out to be bitter. So stop at this point. In 5 minutes you can cook and add water how much ever you need and bring it to the consistency for what you want. This curry will be very tasty for idli dosa combination, and you can have it with rice. And this curry stays for 2 days, so you can keep it in fridge and you can have it next day as well. Next day it gives even more better taste than on the same day of preparation. So it's like similar to that of fish curry or how we do. Now add the tamarind water. So always any dish, once the vegetable gets cooked, then only you need to add the tamarind water. Here as well, after the banana flour gets cooked, then I'm adding the tamarind water. Now with all the masalas, I've added 1/2 tablespoon of jaggery. So the main intention of adding jaggery is it connects the salt and the tamarind taste together and it brings the flavor. It is a kind of food science. If you don't add jaggery where you are adding tamarind and salt, so the taste will not be complete. So whenever you are adding a combination of salt and tamarind, pinch of jaggery should be there to bring to the complete stage. So cooking is all about a science. So you need to do experiments. You need to know which combination, why we are using it, why particular ingredient we are using in particular recipe. So it's a very interesting thing to do. And yummy curry is ready. I'm going to eat with this rice. So if you like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel and share with your friends and family. If you try this recipe, share your recipe pic to the email ID given below. So this banana flour is having a lot of positive things. It is very good for stomach. It is a natural antidepressant. It reduces the risk of heart attack and it has a lot of health benefits. Do try and enjoy your day. Thanks for watching.